WHDD Robin Hood Radio. I'm Jonathan H., and welcome to the School of Jazz. This is program number 22, and this is where we bring you some of the great classic performances from the 1950s until present time. And tonight we're going to take a look at the genre in jazz called hard bop. I touched upon this very subject in an earlier program and had quite a response. So tonight, let's take a good look again at hard bop. All right, and so in order to understand hard bop, we need to start with bop. Bop was the movement started in the 1940s between Charlie Parker, Dizzy Gillespie, Thelonious Monk, and maybe a few others, where instead of improvising on the melody, that is, improvising around the melody, repeating the melody as had been done earlier in the swing era and even earlier, these musicians started to improvise on the chords or the chord changes underneath the melody. The result of this was that you got a much more complex improvisation, one that was deeper and one that required more of the listener and perhaps the musicians. So generally, as a result of this, you've got long lines of improvisation, very complex lines. Also, some very fast improvisation took place, which was not the case in earlier years. There was a speeding up of the improvisation and the tempo at which songs were played in many cases, not all. All right, so let's listen to the ultimate bebop here to start with, so you can compare that later to hard bop, which I will explain after we hear these two performances by Charlie Parker, The Bird, and Dizzy Gillespie. This is from their famous concert at Massey Hall, and this is the quintet: Dizzy Gillespie trumpet, Charlie Parker alto saxophone, Bud Powell piano, Charles Mingus bass, and Max Roach drums, May 15th, 1953. Listen closely to Charlie Parker solo on these two pieces, and you're going to hear a true genius at work. This guy could improvise. Thank you.
Thank you.
And now I would like to play Soir en Tunis, A Night in Tunisia.
Thank you.
All right. Well, there you go. That was the quintet: Charlie Parker, Dizzy Gillespie, Bud Powell, Max Roach, Charlie Mingus Jazz at Massey Hall. That is a classic, and that shows you exactly what bop was. Now, that was recorded in 1953. Bop was running from the mid-40s to 53, and then we started to get changes, and now we're going to phase into what we term hard bop. There were actually two strains going on that were not counter to, but which changed bop. That is, which instead of following along the line of Charlie Parker and Dizzy Gillespie, found new territory. One was the cool school of jazz. This was a school where the music was very laid back, relaxed, cool, and that's why it's called that. Miles Davis made breakthroughs in that area. Lenny Tristano with Lee Konitz and Warren Marsh. There was a whole group, but that's not what we're pursuing tonight. Tonight we're going to take the other strain which broke away from bop, and that was hard bop. Hard bop is actually an extension of bebop, an example of which we just heard. But the difference is that hard bop incorporates influences from rhythm and blues, gospel music, and blues itself. You'll hear this in the saxophone playing, the piano playing, even the guitar playing. So that is the difference. And hard bop actually brought back some needed popularity to jazz because bebop was pretty cerebral, pretty mind-oriented, frankly, for many people. And hard bop gave some soul, as it were, back into the music. One of the very earliest examples of a hard bop is something by the Miles Davis All-Stars called Walkin', and it's from the CD of the same name, Walkin'. And this features Miles Davis, trumpet, J.J. Johnson, trombone, Lucky Thompson, tenor sax, Dave Shilkraut, alto sax, Horace Silver, piano, Percy Heath, bass, and Kenny Clark, drums. And you're going to hear the first elements of hard bop in this following historic performance from April 1954, barely a year after the Massey Hall performance I played you at the beginning of this section. Thank you. Well, that was Miles and his All-Stars in April 1954, a huge influence on hard bop. However, chronologically, there actually was an earlier performance by the well-known Art Blakey and the Jazz Messengers. Which performance, the Miles or the Art Blakey, was more influential, I cannot say. However, I will tell you that this Art Blakey performance was in February 1954, a few months before the Miles Davis walking. And we're going to hear Art Blakey, A Night at Birdland, Volume 2, with Clifford Brown on trumpet, one of the greatest jazz musicians of all time, Lou Donaldson, alto sax, Horace Silver, piano, Curly Russell, bass, and Art Blakey, drums. This group, Art Blakey and the Jazz Messengers, carried the hard bop genre forward in time for many, many years. So let's take a listen to Now's the Time, Art Blakey, A Night at Birdland. Thank you. right. So you just heard from Art Blakey and the Jazz Messengers, A Night at Birdland, Volume 2, and their performance of Now's the Time. You're listening to WHDD Robin Hood Radio, and I'm Jonathan H. with the School of Jazz. And we're reviewing Hard Bop here tonight, and we hope you're enjoying it. And if you are, we would really appreciate your support. You can make a tax-deductible donation by going to our website, robinhoodradio.com, and going to the Donate section on the website, and make your donation with your credit card. And if you do that, please put down what show you're supporting. If it's this show, it's the School of Jazz. However, if you wish to pay by check, you can do that as well. Just make your check out to Tri-State, TRI-State, Public Communications Incorporated, and send your check to WHDD, 67 Main Street, Sharon, Sharon, Connecticut, 06069. And once again, put on the check what show you're supporting. We really appreciate your donations, and of course, they are fully tax deductible. All right, so let's get back to the jazz here, and specifically, let's get back to Hard Bop. We're going to now move forward in time into 1956, and now we are into real hard bop. And we're going to hear a CD by the Clifford Brown and Max Roach Quintet, Study in Brown. And this features Clifford Brown on trumpet, Max Roach drums, Harold Land tenor saxophone, George Moreau bass, and Richie Powell piano. We're going to hear two tunes that are representative of hard bop. The first is Land's End, and the second is Sandu. Both of these are knockout, not to mention the playing of Clifford Brown, which is absolutely celestial. He is one of the greatest figures in jazz. And what you're about to hear is a harbinger of what follows in the later 50s and throughout the 60s. So sit back and take a listen to the great Clifford Brown and Max Roach Quintet. Thank you. Listening to WHDD Robin Hood Radio, and I'm Jonathan H. with the School of Jazz. and we are delving into the genre of jazz entitled hard bop. In the first section of this program, I gave you a bit of a history, a chronological history of hard bop, where it came from, what were some of the first performances. Now we're just going to play a series of records and CDs that demonstrate hard bop and where it went and what it became, including some of the big hits. And one of the advantages of hard bop to jazz was that it was quite popular. That is, it was easy to listen to. It had soul, as it were. It had that gospel bluesy feeling, and this gave jazz a much-needed infusion of popularity again. So let's start out here with the great Art Blakey, who was instrumental in the development of hard bop, and we're going to hear his classic CD, Moanin', Art Blakey and the Jazz Messengers. Lee Morgan on trumpet, Benny Golson tenor sax, Bobby Timmons piano, Jimmy Merritt bass, and the great Art Blakey on drums. Moanin'. Thank you. Well, yes. I mean, that is just beautiful. And there you go. You get the idea. Kind of a funky groove, beautiful playing, great musicianship. I mean, you don't get any better than that. I threw a second one in there by Art Blakey. It's called Dat Dare. And that was recorded in 1960, and that featured Lee Morgan on trumpet, the great Lee Morgan, the incredible Wayne Shorter on tenor sax, Bobby Timmons piano, Jimmy Merritt bass, and Art Blakey drums. Now, that was 1960, and just before that, in 1958, October, I played you The Moanin', which I announced earlier. So you just got a taste of two of the great hard bop hits of Art Blakey and the Jazz Messengers. And notice something here. These are great, great musicians. Art Blakey attracted some of the greatest musicians of all time to his groups, and you're hearing the best. All right, so let's move on. Now we're going to hear something that was quite a smash hit when I was in college in the 60s, and this is by Lee Morgan, and it's called The Sidewinder. And it features Lee Morgan on trumpet, Joe Henderson tenor sax, Barry Harris piano, Bob Crenshaw bass, and Billy Higgins drums. And here again, look at the quality of personnel that are gathered around these hard bop recording sessions. All right, so let's play the Lee Morgan Sidewinder, and after that I'm just going to play you a long series of other hard bop great performances. Sit back and enjoy. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.